Well, good morning, guys, and welcome back. It's Wednesday morning. I didn't leave last night for Port Hedland. They wanted me to go tonight, which was not possible because I was gonna get back on Saturday lunchtime around there, which didn't work because the truck is booked at Volvo on Saturday morning for service, and I got some other stuff to do as well, so I have to be back Friday. And because of that, they gave me a different run. I'm going to Abra gold mine. It's about 200 kilometers northwest of Miketara. So past Miketara, I'm turning left at the 26 parallel parking bay, or in other words, towards Horseshoe Mine, and keep going for another about 170 kilometers on dirt until I get to Abra. This is my new run.
Keep
right. Well, for this week only.
Keep right.
And
this load on here, mate. Instant.
To be honest, I wasn't too happy to wake up 4 o'clock in the morning. Never done that for a long time, and it's not something that I really enjoy doing it. The latest I can wake up is 5:30. Even then it's a bit yuck, but my ideal time it's 7:30, 8, something like that. So yeah, leaving depot at 6 a.m. when the traffic is just about to start. I'll be so happy to be out of this town before the real peak hour start. A lot of impatient drivers, I can tell you that much. And yeah, usually when I'm leaving in a evening before coming to depot, after leaving home, I'm stopping at IGA and buying what I need, few bits and pieces. Got the majority of stuff from home, but still need a bit of pieces from IGA. But this morning I was closed, so I only need to stop at Mushai and buy it from there. So I'm just hoping by the time I get to Auburn that you have to be a bit more civilized. I know it's wishful thinking, but yeah, we'll see how it goes. Of a daylight. Usually it's taking me about 40 minutes from depot to Mushai. Now it's already 43 minutes and I still have 17 k's to go. And I didn't got the worst of the morning traffic. No, I was just about to start it, so I still got lucky. Quick stop at Mushai, buy some stuff and try to Auburn, get the third trailer. Outside.
Take the ramp, then take the ramp.
Yeah, shut up.
Use the left lane to take the slip road.
Nah. Got some business to do.
In 50 meters, at the roundabout, take the second exit onto the National Highway 95 ramp.
Not gonna happen.
Exit the roundabout onto the slip road, then use the right lane to take the slip road to National Highway 95.
Oops.
Head east. Continue for 600 meters. East on National Highway 95. Continue on National Highway 95 for 1.5 kilometers.
Nope. Okay. Okay. Let's go.
Turn left onto Mercury Rise, then continue onto National.
Yeah,
head west on Mercury Rise. In 200 meters, continue onto National Highway 95. Continue onto National Highway 95, then slide right to stay on National Highway 95. Slide right to stay on National Highway 95. In 100 meters, at the roundabout, take the third exit onto the National Highway 95 ramp. Lane to take the slip road to National Highway 95, then merge onto National Highway 95. Hoping to get there on a daytime, but that's not gonna happen. They didn't want me to leave last night. Driving on dirt will be blurry night time, where I can't see anything. And since it's first time going there, it's gonna be fun. Yep, going as usual, blindfolded. I have to figure out everything on pitch dark.
live in Derry and it's 12 degrees.
I'm very off-white.
Cold out here. I don't like it. I'm too used with the weather up there. This 12. Nah. I don't like it anymore. About driving daytime. You get stuck behind oversizes and there's nothing you can do. Especially in between Perth and Uban. Your only hope is the overtaking lines. Part of that. And you are hoping that overtaking line it's on a flat or uphill, not downhill. Because this guy, when he's going downhill, he's going 105, no worries. He's actually running away from me down here. I had a chance to get around. I've been stuck behind him for the last 30 k's. Yeah, so it's always a bit interesting when you go somewhere for the first time and you go there at night time on a dirt with a triple. You don't know what you expect. So yeah, don't know what to expect tonight either. We'll see what may be out there. Who knows? We're lucky enough, we may see some strange animals. Who knows? Maybe some strange galactic creatures, UFOs, who knows what's out there? It's always, don't know. So yeah. It's gonna be interesting. But first thing first, let's see what's waiting at Woburn. Because after all, that's the most interesting place. You don't know what to expect there. Depot. let's see. My dog, it's been dropped here last night, so who knows where or what's going on. That means if I see a parking bay, I'll take it and go for a walk. I'm not gonna drive around to look for my dog, just hoping that it's in a good position to hook up and go. No, 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 I'll just take a bay and go for a walk, because by the time I'll do all the driving around, may not have any base. Well, saying that, looks a bit empty in the front. Doesn't look bad. But obviously, I can't see my dog being on the front. So, one, two. Oh yeah, plenty. Three. Oh yeah, plenty base. Plenty base. Nah, my dog no, is not here, so. Let's go for a quick drive around. I want 9535. Yeah, definitely not around here where it's easy to hook up, so I'll just park and get the trailer there. Five, is this one here? Yep. Yeah. It's not in a good spot.
Southbound out of Luka.
Okay. So, that's where the problem is. I can't use the trailer as a dog, because that's the heaviest out of all of them. And it's heavy by far compared with the two that I got. So it's gonna be a lead. In order to do that, of course I have to move the dolly. So I have to pull out the dolly from the front of the trailer. Jesus, what was here last night? It was a bit of mayhem, the way the trailers are parked. Okay, so since I'm pulling out the dolly, I'll put it right under the other trailers. I'm not gonna drop it here and then then I'll just hook up on the other trailer, come back here, hooked on, and I'm done. Okay. And this is the easiest way. Since I already had the trailer hooked up behind the prime mover, yeah, just right under. Have a look. They parked across all the way to the end of the lines. They physically blocked the whole driveway. Okay. Okay. Yep, all hooked up. Beautiful. Yep. Container locked. Yep. Don't you love these dog runners? So obviously something is wrong. Not catching. gonna see if we have a winner. Not yet. So I need to go even higher. No, well, looks like we need a spanner or something. Let's pull it up. Looks like the tread is a bit stopped at that point, but then still let's see. Bit more. Okay. I'll do a bit more. Yep, it's locked. It's locked. So you know it's not gonna fall apart. When you see something like this, you go straight to the workshop, get them to fix it. But people don't care. It's someone else's problem, not theirs. Okay, so let's go. So let's see how we make it. May get to Mika before the 5 hours to get some fuel and have a lunch, or may have to stop for lunch before that. It's all how quick we go up these hills. The last two are not that heavy, but the front one it is. And they set up that one as a dog. No way in the world I can take that as a dog. The heaviest one at the back. Okay, fine. Up that blurry thing. It's a nightmare for us. Alright, I may be able to get it to BP Mikatara right within 5 hours. It all depends what I'm gonna catch from here to there. I still got 3 hours and 20 minutes to drive and 330 k's to go, so yeah, it all depends. I don't know if this guy really should be on a road or not. That combination is stopped. Dog trailer on a fog line, the prime mover on a center line. It's crooked ass. it's plenty wrong here, so... Okay, lunchtime, and then Mikatara to get some fuel and from there towards the mine site. Alright, left queue, next Mikatara, get some fuel, check the load before getting on dirt and yeah. We'll see what happens from there. Yeah, and there we go. 5.5. Everything has to do with the cost. Keep the cost at minimum. Happy. because I've already used half of the tanks and I'm not going into unknown with half tanks of diesel. Even that I only have, well, a return trip 530 kilometers, yeah. That's not gonna happen. Need to leave from here with full tanks. So let's see if I can go in BP. If not, Shell will do. But BP is first on the list. Okay. This is confusing. Ice pack, but it's toolbox. Toolbox. And the proper ice pack is on this side, which is exactly mirror image of the other box. So we go with number 2 and number 4. Okay, so multiple 2, 4. Next. $20.9, so $2.21. Oh, not this. This is number two. Well, we're going on dirt, so I have to be tied up. Come on. Everything looks good. This is something normal. Still going, the other one still going. Okay. Okay, 310 liters on this side. 310 on this side. So 620. Need to get the receipt. Come on. Yep. We are done. Checking again. For everything to be okay when I get to the 26 parallel parking bay, which is in about 70 kilometers from here. And then we leave the highway. The first or 50 kilometers are sealed apparently, and after that it's all dirt. About 140 kilometers dirt. get to the 26th parking bay. And right after that is my turn off. So just in case the oversize is behind me wants
to go. In 800 meters, turn left onto Ashburton Downs Mika Thara Road.
In case the oversize wants to go in here to have their brake, I'll turn left and stop there.
Turn left onto Ashburton Downs Mika Thara Road.
Okay, final check. These guys are going to Horseshoe or to Abra. I hope not to Abra.
In 500 meters, keep right to stay on Ashburton Downs Mika Thara Road. Keep right to stay on Ashburton Downs Mika Thara Road.
I can't see any left.
Continue for 10 kilometers. northwest. Continue for one. Head northwest on Ashburton Downs Meekatharra Road. Continue on Ashburton Downs Meekatharra Road for 105 kilometers.
What you guys doing? This is the worst thing you can do, mate, going with 20. You'll feel every blurry thing.
You want to go a bit quicker in the Volvo, you might as well go around.
Thanks, mate. Best I found around in between 40 and 60. I'm loaded. They're empty. Ideal speed. 167 kilometers to go. Kilometers an hour. This is the reason why I done all the checking, double checking, triple checking, everything. It's a long way on the dirt. Plenty cows on the right side. Cows on the left. Like someone else was passing through here, going in the same direction. It's a bit of dust on the side of the road in a bush. Dust. slowly, slowly we're getting to the dark side. Ideal speed, it's 60. You go to 50, 54. Already feeling the corrugation. Get close to 60, everything is all right. You go too much over 60 and not safe anymore. So basically 60 is the sweet spot. Cruising, still in control, don't feel corrugation, just perfect. Just past the turn off to Horseshoe. Funny thing is, everywhere you go on any road, doesn't matter if it's dirty, if it's sealed, you see a speed limit signs. Well, I never saw one since I left the highway. Guys ask me what the speed limit is on this road, I have no idea. It can't be less than 60, that's for sure, but yeah, don't know. What is 60, 80, 90? forget about phone coverage around here. The only coverage I have is when I get there on the site, because yeah, they got an antenna. This is Gascoyne River. When it's raining, forget about crossing. This area is all flooded. Saw a few desperate kangaroos, and well, look, the cows were sleeping on the side of the road. Like they don't have enough room anywhere else to sleep. They have to sleep on a road. good on you. You turn right in time. Come on. Can't they sleep anywhere else? K's to go. K's left. eyes left. Yay. Skip. Run. It's on my right hand side. You can see the beacons, but now my big dilemma is where to park for the night. Is there enough room to park this blurry thing around the camp there or not? Still don't have front coverage yet. There's a processing plant on my right. Camp, it's a bit further up. Probably this is the road that I have to turn in the morning. Of the village access road. beautiful. I can park here. Okay, so we are all done, we are here. Well, that's all for the night. We'll see you guys in the morning. So till then, take care and be safe.